Welcome everyone to my free online tutorial for the new SAT math section. Today I'm going to discuss a problem taken from the official SAT study guide released by College Board. This is a problem taken from the first exam, problem number 3, in the section where calculator is allowed. Okay? So this is a typical geometry problem. It tests your understanding of certain angles when it comes to parallel lines and determining their value. So in this problem they give you a certain value and they ask you to find the value of a second given angle in the picture. So let's read this. In the figure above, lines L and M are parallel, okay, so they're parallel, and lines S and T are parallel. So you have two pairs of parallel lines. So you can think of L and M as parallel lines and SAT and S and T as parallel transversals, okay? So then it asks you, if the measure of angle 1 is 35 degrees, what is the measure of angle 2, right? So you know for sure that angle 1 measures 35 degrees. You just need to find the measure of angle 2 in the picture, right? So in this video, I'm going to teach you several ways to solve this problem. The first way that quickly comes to mind for me, for example, is noticing that this, since these two lines are parallel, they create a parallelogram. Do you notice this parallelogram? And what I mean is, if in my solution here, you'll see a slightly altered picture with added angles. Don't mind these all of these angles yet, but just take a look at this picture. So you see this parallelogram that I marked with light green color. This parallelogram makes it easy to find the angle measure for angle 2. Right, so the first thing that you know that 1 and 3 are vertical angles. You see these two angles are vertical, and vertical angles must be equal in measure, so they're congruent. So 1 and 3 must measure 35 degrees, each of them, right? And they're both equal in measure. And the reason why I brought up this picture with a parallelogram in it is because you know that in a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal in measure, right? So you know that since 3 and 1 are vertical angles, and 3 and 4 are equal because they're opposite angles, you know that angle measure of 4 is equal to the angle measure of 1, right? Now, since you know that 4 measures 35 degrees, then you know that angle 2 is supplementary with angle 4, right? So you know that their sum, because M is a straight line and S is a transversal, so these two must be supplementary, 2 and 4. In other words, their sum is equal to 180 degrees. So that means that if angle 4 measures 35 degrees, then angle 2 must measure 180 minus 35, which is 145 degrees in measure. Right? So that's the first quickest way of figuring this out, the angle measure of angle 2. Now, let's think of other ways of doing it. So now comes the explanation of why I drew so many angles. So first of all, I drew them all in one color because they're all equal, and I will explain to you why they're all congruent. So first of all, as we said earlier, 1 and 3 are vertical angles. Angles 1 and 3 are vertical, both 35 degrees in measure, right? So that should be clear. Now, angles 1 and 5, which is this one and this one, are corresponding angles, right? They're corresponding because we have a straight line L and two parallel transversals, S and T. So that means that 1 and 5 are equal in measure, and they're called corresponding angles. So angle 5 measures 35 degrees as well. Okay? Now let's think of another set we can see. Angles 6 and 4. Now, before we go to 6, we need to understand. So since we know that 5 is equal to 35 degrees in measure, angle 5, that means, notice that angle 6 is a vertical angle with respect to angle 5. So angle 6 and 5 are vertical angles. So that means angle 6 also measures 35 degrees, right? So now that we know what angle 6 means, we can read this. Angle 6 and 4 are alternate interior angles, right? These two angles, angle 4 and angle 6, are alternate interior angles. And you know, from properties of transversals and two parallel lines, that these two parallel lines, L and M, together with a transversal S, a straight line, right, S, make it happen that angle 6 and 4 are alternate interior angles and they're equal. Right? So this is a property that you should remember. This is probably very easy to remember, to see it, because they're very close together and you know that they're equal. Right? Now, let's think of the result. Thus, angles 1, 3, 4, 5, and 6 all measure 35 degrees, right? So each of these angles measures 35 degrees, each of these red angles I marked, right? Now, the last thing that you should notice is that angle 6, right? In my last sentence, angles 6 and 2 are consecutive interior angles, right? Consecutive meaning that their sum must equal 180 degrees, right? They're consecutive, they're not adjacent, because adjacent means that they're separated by a line, right? They're not separated by a line, they're consecutive, right? Consecutive interior angles. Interior because they're inside, right? They're kind of squashed by two parallel lines L and M. That's why they're called interior. So they're consecutive interior angles, and their sum is equal to 180 degrees, right? And you could have found that out because you knew that if angles 6 and 4 were equal, because they were alternate interior angles, and you knew that since angle 4 and 2 are supplementary, then logic suggests that angles 6 and 2 are also supplementary. But it's just a different way of looking at it, and there's a different name for this pair of angles, 6 and 2, right? In any case, their sum is equal to 180 degrees, and thus angle 2 measures 180 minus 35, 145 degrees. Okay? So these are just a few ways of doing this problem. So as a result, the correct choice is D, 145 degrees.